Okay, thank you, Samus. So welcome everybody to the last section of our symposium. We are happy also to have you here today. So my name is Khalifa Al-Qalina, and I'm emergency physician in year three. Today I'll be talking about heavy metal toxicity, which is, I think, is an interesting topic and challenging at the same time. So at the end of the presentation, So at the end of this presentation, we will be knowing what's lead toxicity, mercury toxicity, and we'll talk about some home messages. So as a start, I'll give you one case. It is 45 years old man presented with difficulty walking and fatigue. His vital were within normals. His physical examination was significant for pale conjunctiva and foot drops. His serum electrolyte were all normals. You did a CBC for him, showed he's having hypochromic anemia. So from the history, he told you that he is drinking water directly from a steel pipe at home. So I think from this history, now you know what this patient is having. So this patient actually having lead toxicity. I'll speak about it now. So what's lead toxicity? It's a common public health problem, particularly in developing countries. People are exposed to lead through many sources, including contaminated food, waters, manufacturing of car acid batteries, bins, pipes, steel, and bronze. Some people also, especially traditional old people, doing lead directly to the wounds, so umbilical stump in the children's. So chronic toxicity might result from oral exposure to low doses of lead through food or water, and sometimes occupational sources like the people working in manufacturing of cement and this kind of stuff. So what's other sources that can be missed when we are taking history from the patient? So we have to know if the patient living in old houses, as you can see in these pictures. Some toys you buy to your children sometimes has been with a lead equipment or lead containing materials. Also some kind of spices that imported from other countries, sometimes it contained lead mercuries, lead inside it. So they cover it, they cover the spices, so it will be preserved for a long time. For this kind of thing, they use like lead type of materials. Also traditional remedies, like Indian remedies, also they sometimes use lead. And we have to know if the people are using old steel pipe at homes, and if they are having some of the family working in the factories that dealing with lead production. So what's the symptoms that patient might have? Initially, all stages or initial stages of the symptoms might be vague and non-specific. So the patient, if presented with symptoms, might present with lethargy, headache, GI symptoms, anemia. We have to know if it is chronic or acute also. What if the patient having ingested large amount of lead, so he will have acute toxicity? And he might have multi-organ toxicity like nephropathy, neuropathy, encephalopathy, coma, and hepatitis. But if there is a chronic exposure, especially in children, you have to think if the patient presented with intellectual impairment, behavioral problem, low IQ, hearing problem, and developmental delay. Also, chronic exposure in adults can lead to infertility. So here, the symptoms of the patient actually will depend on the lead level. As you can see in this table, I would say if the patient having 10 microgram per deciliter of lead, in adult they might have no symptoms. But in children, they might decrease, having a symptom of like decreased hearing, decreased growth, or decreased IQ. But if the patient having high amount of lead, like 100 microgram per deciliters, it will be, the patient will have encephalopathy, death, and if the adult having 100% of lead in their blood, they will have like encephalopathy, and in children, it might lead to death. So what is differential diagnosis if you are having a patient with this kind of symptoms? Because lead poisoning can be confused with other neuropathy, because as we said, it can lead to like a neurological manifestation. So you will be confusing with carpal tunnel syndrome or Guillain-Barré syndromes. So you have to put in mind this neurological presentation. Also, you will be confused with abdominal pathologies. You will like said, this might be gastroenteritis or nephrolithiasis or appendicitis. But from the history, you can dig more to know what's your diagnosis, especially if the patient coming recurrently to you with the same complaint. Also, subtle neuropsychiatric sign in children. If the children present with abnormal behavior or low IQ, sometimes they'll be misdiagnosed as attention deficit hyperactivity disorder and other behavioral disturbance. So how you will investigate your patient? As we said, you can do CBC to look for anemia, you will do LFT to look for any complication, and you have to send blood lead level. Also, you can send a blood film. You might see basophilic stippling, as you can see in this picture, how it looks. And you can send bone profile, urine dipstick to see for other complication caused by lead toxicity. Also, we have to do abdominal X-ray to see, because if there's a large ingestion, it will be radio-opaque in the X-rays. And in pediatric, if they are having chronic exposure to lead, they will have like metaphyseal lead lines, as I'll show you in the X-rays now. So this X-ray here showing you what is metaphyseal lead line and why it is happening. Because if there is lead toxicity, there will be hyperactive metaphyseal, so it will look like this in the X-rays. And if the patient also took or ingested orally lead materials, it will be radio-opaque in the X-rays, as you can see also in this X-ray. So what's the treatment? If you have patient, actually the treatment mainly emergency treatment or supportive treatment. But the most important treatment step in lead poisoning is to remove the patient from the source. And if the patient having seizure at that time, you can give diazepam. And you can start IV fluid if he's having like hypotension. The decontamination for heavy metals like lead, never ever give activated charcoal, and it did not bind to heavy metals. And consider whole bowel irrigation if you are seeing radio-opaque X-ray, يعني showing you radio-opaque materials. And it depends actually on the amount you see in the X-rays. If the small amount, you can give repetitive laxative. It will like the metal will be coming out with the stool. But if it is a large amount, you go ahead with doing whole bowel irrigation. So the antidote, I will not spend much time in the antidote because I don't think that you have it in the health center. So it depends actually the antidote on the lead level on the blood. If it is below 45, between 45 or below, you can give succimir. If it is not available, we'll give bensalamine. And actually the side effect of succimir, including nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and elevation of liver enzymes. If the level between 45 to 69, again, you can give succimir with iodate calcium disodium. But if the patient having encephalopathy, you can give them combined dimercaprol with iodate calcium disodium. So what is the disposition? Asymptomatic children and asymptomatic adults should be counseled on how to avoid future exposure and given a close follow-up with their primary care provider. Also to repeat the lead level and to evaluate the exposure if they are living in old houses or they have some of their relatives working on the factories that deal with lead. Also, you have to call poison center for follow-up in the family, because if the one member of the family having the lead toxicity, maybe there is something at their home and can lead to other symptoms to other partner in the family. So let's move to a second case. I have 24 years old Omani male presented to emergency department with history of abdominal pain and vomiting after ingestion of mercury. His examination apart from mild abdominal tenderness is not significant and his vital within normal. And he fortunately brought to you a bottle containing mercuries. So what you will do in this patient, this is his x-ray. It showed all the bowel is containing the materials of mercury inside. For this patient, I said he's vitally stable. If he's fully alert, you can do whole bowel irrigation. So this patient definitely having mercury toxicity because they give you in the history. So what's mercury toxicity? It's used in petroleum development, industries, electrical equipment, thermometer, disc, batteries, plastic, antiseptic, and antifungal agent. Also, it can be used as herbal medication for the skin intestinal disorder. It's actually existed in three forms, elemental, organic, and inorganic. I need you to know elemental could be like ingested orally or can be inhalated. If it is orally ingested, it will be non-toxic or non-absorbed by GI. But if it is inhalated, it can lead to devastating symptoms like respiratory symptoms and CNS symptoms. But the most familiar form of mercury is elemental metallic mercury. So what is the sources of mercury? Mercury, you can get it actually from the air, you can get it from the water, contaminated water, from fish, or specify what kind of fish in coming moments. Amalgam filling using to the teeth and cosmetic lotion also, and some kind of vaccine to preserve them. They use like mercury elements. So this kind of fish, actually it's more than 15. You need to look at them. You need to know the names because they are naturally having mercury level inside. So we have like at the top, Gulf tillyfish, swordfish, shark, macos, and kick mackerels, and so on. But in this slide, you need to know that fish is a common source also of mercury, especially of patients having high fish diet. We have to be aware يعني, if the patient is having symptom of toxicities. So actually, the symptom will depend on the route of the exposure, the type of mercuries, and the level. So if the inhalation, as shown in this table, if the patient having inhalation of metallic mercury, they might have hypoxemia, dyspnea, chest tightness, fever, chills, and might have nausea, vomiting also. If the patient having chronic inhalation, they will develop might form fever, which is because of the inhalation of the mercuries. Also, they might have neuropsychiatric symptoms, renal dysfunction, skin changes. If the patient having exposed to organic mercuries, which is also chronics, because the symptom of acute, actually, it will be almost the same between the lead and the mercuries. So if they're having organic mercury, which is chronic exposure, they might have delayed neurological symptoms like ataxia, tremors, dysarthria, visual disturbance, hearing loss, spasticity, and hyperreflexia. So how you will manage this patient? Actually, this patient, the management is mainly supportive. And mainly supportive or whole bowel irrigation actually. And you have to send them for nearest hospital if they are having acute ingestion. But also patients should be removed from the source. You have to know there is no role for prophylactic antibiotic or steroids. And sometimes these people inject actually mercury to the skin. So if the patient having self-injection of metal mercury, he might require surgical debridement of the infiltrated tissue. So we have to be aware of that also. So again, the antidote, I will not spend much of time. It's dimercaprol, which is abbreviation as BAL, is used for clinically significant acute inorganic mercury intoxication. But don't use the BAL for mercury fever or methyl mercury. Instead, give saximir, which is abbreviated as DIMSA. Why we are not giving BAL? Because if we give BAL to this type of mercury, it might increase the mercury crossing the blood-brain barriers. So we have to give DIMSA, not to give BAL. So home messages, the gastrointestinal decontamination method of lead and mercury toxicity with radiological evidence is whole bowel irrigation. So lead and mercury is whole bowel irrigation. young children under age of 5 are more susceptible to have lead toxicity. Also, so we have to keep in mind any patient with big symptoms or delay neurological symptoms, we have to think about lead mercury and dig more in the history. Elemental mercury is non-toxic to the gastrointestinal tract, but elemental mercury can be severely, having